Happy Wednesday from Target, and every Target card is broken now because there's so many people out here shopping. Fighting the crowds the day before, I guess there's not really a crowd here. Day before Thanksgiving shopping. And
what?
Can you please buy that for yourself?
Oh, that's so cute. That is so cute.
Yeah, it is.
Should we get it?
Yep.
Oh, I'm gonna get it.
And you're gonna wear it tomorrow to cook Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, I'm not cooking dinner, I'm just showing up.
You're gonna cook what? Some stuff.
I'll wear it tonight because we have to make scones and Brussels sprouts.
Yeah. Be awesome.
And I'll wear my red lipstick.
Yeah.
Oh, it's gonna be so cute.
And
I'll drink champagne.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's gonna be awesome. You're gonna be like, what's that lady?
Smorgy Borgy.
No. I was thinking of the lady that always drinks wine. She's like, a little bit for this and then some for me. The big lady. What's
Giada?
Her name?
Oh, the big lady.
Yeah.
The Contessa? The barefoot Contessa?
No, she's like really old.
Julia Child?
Yeah.
She's dead.
Oh. By the way, it started out ugly as all get out today, and it turned out to be beautiful. We're at Sam's now. What's up with this weird screen that has a couple of chairs behind it? Is this where you get your immunization shots? That's weird. Look at how beautiful the sky is tonight. It looks like a painting. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna give you guys the panoramic view of Florida with that awesome like tow truck noise in the background. Oh, there it is, getting purple, dog's barking, stuff's happening. Right, I'm gonna try to show this off. It's definitely not popping as much as it is here, like in person. It's way cool looking, like all of it. Look at this random plane flying, or is it, there it is, random plane flying through. Why does my camera keep getting blurry? Like, I'm not doing anything crazy, I'm just trying to show these clouds. Yeah, you tell them, dogs. Look at how awesome it is. With the moon and everything. Man, I just like stepped out here down the street. Hey, that's like the Christmas shot right there. It's perfect. We're back home, I'm walking the dogs. There's Armani pooping. But here's my favorite thing about when it gets cold. So cool looking. Who's ready to cook some Thanksgiving type stuff? I'm wearing the apron. Who's ready to do some Thanksgiving cooking?
Me.
Yeah,
I am. I'm so excited for this apron. It's so cute. And I think it'll be even cuter when I wash it.
Yeah, because it won't have all like the folds in it.
Yeah, I love it. And I can put like my spoons here.
Or like a beer.
Probably spoons. I think the beer would be in my hand, right?
Like, yeah, that's where bottle of wine in your pocket.
I don't even know, would it fit?
Yeah, look at that. That's how you know it's a real apron.
I'm ready.
Also, on a side note, we got this orange drink.
Oh, yeah.
That we're going to try tonight.
It's mega antioxidant drink.
Originally, we were going to get like a green one, but I remember the last time that we had a green one. Did not taste good at all. So we went with an orange one based off of carrots.
Is it?
Yep. Carrot juice.
What's the first thing listed? Because that's what it has the most of.
Carrots and beets.
Apple.
Apple?
Apple, carrot, peach, and lemon.
So we determined that all of the stuff that we're going to make, we're making like a couple of sides for Thanksgiving tomorrow, it'll taste better if it's fresher. So we're going to make it tomorrow rather than tonight and refrigerate and all the other stuff. It'll take like maybe a half an hour to make it all. Maybe an hour at the most. Probably not an hour. Probably half an hour. But we'll do that tomorrow. But tonight, we are going to make some scones, or at least attempt to make them. I just wanted to say this really quick. Some people have asked me if I'm missing a tooth, because this little patch of mustache hair is very thick. I don't know why.
You're missing teeth?
Kind of looks like it, like if I'm...
Oh my god.
You see that one really like thick patch of hair? Now if they're all there...
Show them all your teeth, so they know.
There they are.
Oh no, you got stuff in your teeth, actually.
Oh, look at that.
Show them the other side so they know, they make sure, yep, okay. This is like real life Snopes, you guys. We totally just Snoped this, and it was false.
Oh, sorry.
Myth busted.
I was gonna say myth busted.
Were you really? Oh, yeah.
No, I don't get it.
You could say...
That's the way the story goes. The dog's like... That's terrible. And he's still sneezing.
Let's make scones.
Scones!
He's allergic to fun.
He is allergic to fun. I also wanted to say, so there's a new Jurassic World coming out. Trailer looks awesome. I feel bad for the T-Rex. He's like the only carnival in all of the Jurassic Park series. Carnivore.
You said carnival.
He's the only carnival in all of the Jurassic Park series that isn't grossly overestimated. Like, the velociraptors are gigantic, but they're not really. Velociraptors were like
3.5 feet tall. And then the Tylosaur, the new one where he jumps out of the water and he eats the great white, that is a gigantic Tylosaur. They're not that big. Their heads are about the size, maybe like a 5 foot tall head. And that's like way smaller than a great white. It wouldn't be able to eat a great white in one bite. Science!
Let's make some scones.
Cranberry pecan scones. It's a Martha Stewart recipe.
And it's very like festive. Like for Thanksgiving because of the cranberry.
Well, I actually only did it because one of you guys mailed us cranberries in the mail, so we have cranberries.
Yeah, these guys from Trader Joe's.
Yeah, so thank you so much because we're going to be using it in our scones. So first we're going to start out with 2 cups of all-purpose flour. Now we're going to use 5 tablespoons of white sugar, white granulated sugar, and 5. So these are... No, it's good. Sorry, there's also a tablespoon for a later purpose, and I was like, did I put too much sugar in these scones? Which probably wouldn't have been that bad of a deal. Like, 1 more tablespoon of sugar.
You know what we call that? What? Americanizing them.
Well, okay, so this is kind of strange, but this is what Martha Stewart says, so we're gonna do it. Tablespoon of baking powder.
Putting it to good use already.
Yeah, there's some water inside of my measuring spoon, which is a little bit strange. So I'm glad I'm wearing this apron. And I just realized the apron that I really wanted was the Minnie Mouse apron, and they actually only make it in like a half apron that doesn't cover the top, and this is pretty close with the polka dots.
Yeah.
So, yay! It's a Thanksgiving miracle.
I like to call it a burlap mini. Because it's made of burlap.
It's not burlap. This is like linen.
Is it?
I think so. Okay, 1/2 tablespoon of salt. Now, we're gonna whisk all of our dry ingredients together. Like that. I think we're good.
It's pretty good to me.
All right, pretty whisked. So now we're going to cut in 6 tablespoons of, they wanted unsalted butter, I just realized, and we only have salted butter, and I already put in the salt. If you have salted butter, you should probably just use like maybe half as much salt. So these may be a little bit salty, but that's okay. So we're gonna cut these in like with a pastry blender, but we don't have a pastry blender. So if you don't have a pastry blender, we'll show you how to do it with knives. Yeah.
Good word, scissor hands.
Yeah, it's like the moon landing.
Is that what the moon landing looked like?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Well,
this is what moon dust looks like.
Does it?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Because Neil Armstrong.
What, did he show you a picture?
I mean, there's video from the moon.
But is it this close up?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I guess I've just never seen moon dust before.
Moon dust is my new band name, and we do...
I'm going to name our first kid that.
Oh, yeah.
Moon dust tracker.
Moon dust or Star Child.
Star Child. His... Oh, my gosh. Her... His... I guess it could be a boy's name. His first name is going to be Moon Dust, and his middle name is going to be Star Child. Moon Dust Star Child Tracker.
I like it.
Can you imagine the when you get your initials like on your robe and stuff, like
MDT?
Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. Oh. That's all I could think of.
No wait, it was, what was it? It was first.
I don't
first
even remember.
Moondust Starchild. MD. But do you think Moondust would be 2 words?
Maybe not. Is Moondust 2 words in real life? Like Moondust?
Yeah. It might be hyphenated.
I don't want to give my kid like a hyphenated, like that just makes their lives so hard.
Yeah. So just moon dust is one word. So M-S-T. M-S-T.
No, it would be M-S-C. Would Star Child be not?
Yeah, it's one word. All one word.
Star Child?
It's
okay.
Like Lamangelo. What are we teaching them now?
We're teaching them how to cut the butter into the flour like this. What? You do it.
So the real way to cut it in. I don't know how Martha Stewart expects to do it with knives, but you can do it with a fork. And all you're doing is just trying to break up the butter so that it gets real tiny and coated so that you get pieces that are... I don't know if you can kind of see, they're like little clumpies. Like this one right here?
Okay.
Like that.
I can dig it.
Can you dig it?
You can dig it, we can dig it, you can dig it, we can dig it.
Can you dig it, baby? I can dig it, you can dig it, we can dig it, they can dig it, they can... I can dig it, baby.
Oh my gosh, we should have a disco baking party.
Disco bacon?
Yeah, not like bacon. Baking.
Can we have a disco baking bacon party?
I mean, sure, we'll serve bacon at this disco baking party. Mm. It's gonna be so awesome!
Can my disco name be Disco Pig?
I can be Lil Ham.
Lil Ham. Lil Ham and Disco Pig.
Can I be the Disco Yeti?
The Disco Yeti, yeah, sure.
Yetina. Can I be the Disco Yetina?
Yetina?
Yeah, because that's like...
Only if...
What's a girl Yeti? Like, is a girl Yeti, does she have like a more feminine name?
I mean, a girl Yeti is just a Yeti still.
I'm going to be the Disco Yetina. Deal with it.
I switched away from the fork to just hands. I just feel like there's not enough butter in here, though.
That's all it told me to use. I'm going to put water, or half and half, in there. So that should help. By the way, a man baking? Yeah.
Well, no, I need an apron. I got flour on my pants.
Do you want to wear my apron?
No.
I'll let you. You are so cute. Look how cute this is on you.
Yeah?
Yes, I think you should have been a girl. Oh, maybe not. You look so adorable in this apron. I cannot. And then you have your little red mixing bowl. So now we're gonna add in 2/3 a cup of half and half. I'm gonna pour it in and you stir it.
All right. Then have me put One Direction on.
Kyle and Mary got me the One Direction, and Jesse too, got me the One Direction CD as part of my birthday gift. And I love it. I just listened to it. This is the very first time we're listening to it. Song number one.
Steal My Girl.
Yes. It's like the perfect like stirring music.
Everybody wanna stir my scones. Everybody wanna put some cranberries. Everybody gonna do this now. Cause we're gonna bake some scones tonight. Dang it. We added half a cup of dried cranberries in there.
Well, the recipe calls for fresh cranberries, and that's not a thing that we have. So you should use fresh cranberries if you can.
But yeah, I think it'll be all right. I don't mind the One Direction in the background, but...
We put in a handful of crushed pecans. We're going to make another batch that does not have nuts in it because one of our friends that's coming tomorrow is allergic to nuts. So we're going to make two.
And then we lightly floured this surface. I didn't show this because I didn't want to get flour all over the camera, but I folded it and kneaded it. Jen folded it and kneaded it.
I didn't do that. No, it's okay. So, but basically what he did is he like flipped it over in half onto itself and then pushed it out to the same size and then flipped it, like, in case you guys don't know how to do it. I didn't know how to do it, so. Now what we're gonna do is cut it like a pizza.
Yeah, the Pizza Hut, the Pizza Hut, Kentucky Fried Chicken in a Pizza Hut.
McDonald's, McDonald's.
And you can, if when you cut it, it sticks to the knife, you can flour the knife if you want to.
Oh, good point.
But
I didn't know you were such a baker.
I mean, I have baked stuff before.
I know you have. Like, in our relationship, you have been the one to bake, like, the most good stuff. Like, one time we made strawberry shortcake. I don't know if you guys remember that. It was, I think, Mother's Day last year. It was so good. It was, like, traditional strawberry shortcake with, like, short, like, biscuits.
I don't even remember making this.
You don't remember making that?
Oh, I think I remember making the biscuits.
Well, because we put our Darth Vader candle on it.
Yes. And
No, it was for your mom's birthday.
I remember this now. Those were good.
I sang, it's your birthday, here's some strawberry shortcake.
Yeah.
Like, na 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 na.
Copyright infringement.
Oh, is it?
No.
Oh.
I did get hit one time for that song, by the way, George Lucas. Brush on a tablespoon and a half of half and half to keep it moist, and then we're going to dust it with some sugar.
This is so much sugar. Is this really what we're supposed to put on it?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what makes it good.
It's kind of a lot. I mean, I thought they might be good before this. I guess they'll be very sweet now.
You know what Martha Stewart says?
What? She says, don't trade Enron.
Don't pay your taxes.
Well, no, that's not why she went to prison.
It's not?
She went to prison for insider trading.
Oh, insider trading. Yeah.
Enron was like, hey, yo, Martha Stewart, just so you know, because we're buds, this company is totally going under. Sell. Now. And she's like, okay. And then they were like, you're going to jail, lady.
Here they are on the pan. We greased the pan just a little bit, only because it's all aluminum foil and this is an old pan. You wouldn't really have to because there's so much butter in there anyways. It'll just, you know, do good on its own. But we wanted to make sure they didn't stick. So a little tiny bit of grease on there. And pop it in the oven for like, it's at 425 for like 10 minutes, 12 minutes maybe. We'll see. Look at them scones, yo! They look good. Remember how I was telling you about the spray in the bottom? This is what happens because there's butter. Like, it's not burnt, but it's a little bit more done than the rest of the scone.
Can you guys hear Night Changes playing in the background?
Oh, jeez. Jen hates her new One Direction CD.
I love it!
Here's how the scones ended up looking.
They turned out delicious. We had one. And I turned out very tired. And as a matter of fact, the bed turned out very warm. It's a little bit cold tonight. So I'm gonna go to bed. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Now it's time to pay the price.